Next one is noise. What is the meaning of noise? It is an unwanted disturbance. It's an unwanted disturbance to send a signal from one point to another point. Maybe these disturbances are due to the internal process or external process. Sometimes these disturbances will come outside of the signal also. So this is said to be noise. This noise should be removed while a transmitter is transmitting the signal from source to the receiver. So that work can be done by transmitter. So what is the use of this transmitter? Transmitter converts the signal which is suitable to transmit. Maybe this is transmitted and the receiver should receive it. Means if the receiver is not able to receive it and identify the voice or the noise, so the transmitter is not properly working, we can confirm that. So transmitter is transmitting the signal which is suitable for the receiver. So which should be filter all the noises, and sometimes while you are filtering the noises, there may be a loss of the signal. This loss of the signal is called attenuation. So what is the meaning of attenuation? Loss in the strength of the signal. Why the loss will occur? What is the reason? When the noises are removed out to transmit the perfect signal to the receiver, there may be a possibility, maybe accidentally or incidentally, for the loss in the strength. This process is called attenuation. This attenuation will be covered with the amplification, otherwise the strength won't be received by the receiver. So next one is receiver. A receiver actually extracts the information which he needs actually from the output of the transmitter. He or she extract the information from the output of the transmitter. This is very, very important. Receiver should be there if a signal was sent or if a message was sent. Without the receiver, it is very difficult to understand the originality of the signal. So this is very, very important. Next one is amplification. What is the meaning of amplification? Increasing the strength of the signal. Strength of the signal. What is the need to increase? Yes, this amplification is the best way to compensate the loss in attenuation. This process, it is useful to compensate the loss in attenuation. As well, we discussed about the attenuation. In the attenuation process, loss was occurred. This loss in the signal was increased and modified in the process of amplification. The minimum energy which is required to increase the strength of the signal will be given by a DC circuit. And the device which is used to amplify the signal is called amplifier. Mostly these amplifiers are manufactured with transistors. So this is the best way to understand the amplification. Now we are going to discuss about the range. This is also one of the important term which is related to the communication system. What is the meaning of range, starting value to ending value? In mathematics, if you are saying find out the range of this series, arithmetic series, progression series, like that. So what is the meaning of range? 0 to infinity. So what in this communication systems, the range is defined as the largest distance. Between the source and receiver. This is the largest distance. That means any FM channel is there. What is the range of that FM channel? Maybe some limits of the sound. After crossing that, it is very difficult to hear the sound. It is very difficult to sense the noise, sense the signal. So the range was over. So what is the largest point between the source to receiver is called range. Next one, bandwidth. What is the meaning of bandwidth? Any communication process, maybe it is a TV, radio, internet, whatever it is, it occupies some portion in the spectrum. So in that portion of the spectrum, some frequency range will be given to that particular transmission of the signals. So the low frequency to the high frequency, or the range of frequency to transmit the signals within a given portion of the spectrum is called bandwidth of the particular signal. The frequency range of a given transmitted wave within the portion occupied in the given spectrum. We will see for which purpose the bandwidth is useful. Means for telecommunications, what is the bandwidth range? For TV programs, what is the bandwidth? TV transmission, what is the bandwidth range? We will see all those things in this case. Next one is modulation. What is the meaning of modulation? Sometimes while you are transmitting the signals, modulation is the best, is a useful way. What is the meaning of that? If you are transmitting the signals, sometimes the signals are with very low frequency. If that low frequency is not possible to send those signals which are with low frequency to the higher altitudes and higher destinations, to the long range. In this case, we should increase the frequency of those signals. So the modulation means increasing the frequency of the signals which are at low frequency. Increasing the frequency of the low frequency signals of the low frequency signals to transfer to large distances. Next one, demodulation. What is this demodulation? Exactly opposite to the modulation. In modulation, low to high. In demodulation, high to low. The retrieval of the input signal, which is sent back to the receiver again. Of the signal from source to receiver. Is called demodulation. Next one, repeater. A repeater, it is a combination of receiver and transmitter. What actually repeaters does? Whenever a signal is there and that signal should be picked by the repeater and it modulates it or modify it and send back to the transmitter again. Whenever it is sending back to the transmitter, there may be a possibility in the change in frequency in terms of amplitude or frequency modulation. So repeater picks the signal from transmitter or receiver and send back the signal to the receiver or transmitter with change in frequency and sends back the signal. So this is very, very important point. What is the use of this repeater? Repeater, sometimes it can extend the range of communication. It extends the range of communication. So these are the main terms which are related to the communication system. Now we can see the bandwidth of signals. So what we can understand with the bandwidth, the frequency range, that is the first basic definition of the bandwidth. But if a signal is transmitting to the receiver, it contains pictures, audio, video, data, many are there. Sometimes music is also one of the signal. So it is very difficult to send all the information for a given frequency. Music has different frequency, speech has different frequency, and remaining computer data or some files are having different frequency. So each and every one, everything which is included in a form of signal has different frequency ranges. We should connect all those things and we should send in a form of signal. This is said to be bandwidth of the signals. Let us suppose for speeches, it is approximately 300 hertz to 3100 hertz. So minimum is 300 hertz, maximum is 3100 hertz. What is the meaning of range of frequencies here? High minus low, 2800 hertz. This much frequency range is needed for the speech signals. So this is said to be bandwidth of the speech signals. Suppose if music is transmitting in a form of signal, music which sometimes it can create overtones, which can create the ultrasonic sound waves also. So what is the frequency of the ultrasonic sound waves? 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz is the audible range. Above 20,000 hertz, nothing but the 2 kilohertz, 20 kilohertz is what is that? Ultrasonic range. Below 20 hertz, infrasonic range. So sometimes the musical instruments have a possibility to produce the ultrasonic sound waves also. That means for music, the frequency should be over 20 kilohertz. Otherwise, transmitting the music signal is not possible to the receiver. So like that, every information in a form of signal, it has their own frequency range. Now we will see one graph which concludes all the things in a different form.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.